Good morning, students. I am Dr. Alok Agrawal and I welcome you on next lecture of our course, that is internal combustion engine. In this class we will study about the working of compression ignition engine. So what will the course the lecture consist of? It will be consist of the working of four stroke compression ignition engine and comparison of FAN CI engine. So to start with working of four stroke engine, first we have to see that what are the basic difference between the two cycles, that is CI engine cycle and SI engine cycle. What are the basic, some fundamental difference between the two? So the first difference is SI engine, the compression ratio is in between 6 to 10, while that of CI engine it is from 16 to 20. So we have seen that compression ratio is the ratio of total volume upon clearance volume. So when the compression ratio is low, it means the total volume is low. So in case of SI engine, the compression ratio is low. So it can be seen that from these two data that the size of the SI engine is less as compared to the size of CI engine. Okay, so this is the first basic difference between the two engines, that is CI engine and SI engine. The second basic difference is that in SI engine, spark ignition engine, during suction stroke, fuel and air mixture are inducted in the combustion chamber, where in case of CI engine, only air is inducted, whereas fuel is injected through fuel injector at the end of compression stroke. Again, it can be seen that with high compression ratio in CI engine, temperature at the end of compression stroke is very high. Because compression ratio is high, so the large amount of fuel is getting compressed into the small amount of fuel in case of CI engine. So the rise in temperature and pressure will be more in case of CI engine as compared to SI engine. So what is happening here? The fuel will get the temperature to self-ignite in case of compression ignition engine, and it is not required a spark plug to initiate the ignition. Okay. A very high pressure fuel pump and fuel injector is required in CI engine instead of a spark plug in SI engine. So in the spark plug we have in SI engine we have a spark plug. In CI engine, this spark plug has to be replaced by a fuel pump to inject the fuel at high pressure in the combustion chamber, and a fuel injector which helps to inject the fuel in the combustion chamber. So again, rest of the things are very similar to the spark ignition engine. Here also, the cycle is completed in four stroke because we are talking about four stroke compression ignition engine or two revolution of crankshaft. Okay. Again, five event has to be completed in four stroke, that is suction, compression, combustion, expansion and exhaust. Each stroke consists of 180 degree of crankshaft rotation as been seen in case of SI engine. So let us start with first stroke, that is suction stroke. Again, here the piston will move from top dead center to bottom dead center. Okay, inlet valve is open during the suction stroke, and here the only air will come inside the cylinder. As in case of SI engine, it is an air and fuel mixture, but here it is only air will enter the cylinder through inlet valve, and suction stroke will end when the piston reaches bottom dead center. So this is the first stroke. This is called suction or intake stroke. Next, second stroke is compression stroke. Here the piston will move from bottom dead center to top dead center. Okay, bottom dead center to top dead center, and both the valve are closed. When the piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, the air inside the combustion chamber start to compress, and because of this high compression ratio of CI engine, the temperature of air at the end of compression is very high. Okay, air compressed from total cylinder volume to clearance volume. So pressure and temperature both are very high because of high compression ratio. So when the piston reaches top dead center, compression stroke ended, and we get a huge amount of air in a very small volume with increased temperature and pressure. This completes two strokes and 360 degree revolution of crankshaft. Now, third one is combustion process. In here, combustion occurs by the injection of fuel. Okay, so at the end of compression stroke, fuel is injected with the help of fuel injector at the head, from the head of the combustion chamber. The rate of injection is such that combustion maintains the pressure constant. Means once, because see, spark is happening momentarily, instantaneously we can give a spark, while fuel injection it requires a certain interval of time. So fuel injection process is occurred some like that, pressure will remain constant, and when we increase the fuel injection, the piston starts moving from top dead center to bottom dead center, so that the pressure will remain constant inside the piston. Okay, during burning, chemical energy for fuel is converted into heat energy. Pressure at the end of combustion increases considerably. When the fuel injection is completed, there will be a huge increase in pressure and temperature, and because of that, the piston will move very fast from top dead center to bottom dead center, and that stroke we called it as the expansion stroke. Again, in this stroke, piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, and both the valves are closed. Inlet valve and outlet valve both are closed. This is the only power stroke in the cycle, and pressure and temperature decreases during this stroke. Okay, so this is the third stroke, expansion stroke. After that, the fuel burns and piston starts ready to move from bottom dead center to top dead center to complete its fourth stroke, that is expansion stroke. Here, inlet valve will be closed and outlet valve will be open, and piston will move from bottom dead center to top dead center, and the complete combustion gases, that is already exhaust gases, we call it the used gases, will come out from the combustion chamber through exhaust valve and exhaust manifold. This stroke is completed when the piston reaches top dead center. Once the piston reaches top dead center, both the valve get closed, and one cycle of operation has been completed, and the piston is ready to perform its second operation by following the same sequence that we have discussed. So this is the working animated picture of working of CI engine, four stroke CI engine. When piston move down, suction stroke, then compression, then sparking is occurring, and then exhaust is occurring. Here it can be seen that how pressure and temperature is getting varied with the motion of the piston. Okay, so when compression occurs, pressure is very high, temperature is very high. When expansion occurs, pressure and temperature both are decreasing. So this is all about working of four stroke SI engine. Now this four stroke SI engine is worked on which cycle? This is diesel cycle. We called it as a diesel cycle, and we also called it a constant pressure heat addition cycle. The only difference between the two cycles is the process of heat addition. In case of auto cycle, the process of heat addition occurs at constant volume, whereas in case of diesel cycle, it is occurring at constant pressure. That's why this diesel cycle is also called constant pressure heat addition. Rest of the stroke, that is intake stroke, is 0 to 1. Suction or intake stroke will remain same. Again, compression stroke will remain same, though here the temperature rises, temperature and pressure rises more because of high compression ratio. Next, there will be expansion stroke from 3 to 4. This is power stroke in which you get output power. Finally, heat rejection at constant volume. Again, heat rejection will occur at constant volume when the piston reaches bottom dead center. And final stroke is exhaust stroke when piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. So the cycle is more or less same. The only difference between the auto cycle and diesel cycle is the process of heat addition. In case of auto cycle, we have seen that heat addition occurs at constant volume, whereas in case of diesel cycle, it occurs at constant pressure. Okay, so this is the working of four stroke CI engine. This is all for today's class. Thank you, class. In next class, we will study a very important topic and a very new topic that we have not studied in basic mechanical engineering, that is valve timing diagram. It is very important, and it is very much that it can come in your exam as well. Okay, thank you.